I am Chief Miles Edward O'Brien. This is fucking spectacular.
So you're blind jumping.
Set the stage for me, baby. Tell me what's happening. Pan around the room.
So the camera starts with a very sweaty chef holding a chip above his head. The camera turns to the rest of the room, standing in a semicircle around him, as they all listen to what the chip is saying. B'Elanna says, "Look, I've got information on the hegemony that could lead to, I'm sure, many things happening, but the most important thing is that I don't have everything. I know what's going on, and I'm actually going to tell you right now. I don't know why I'm trying to pretend. I forget that you guys are going to be with me for the rest of this, and I have no choice." She looks around, as she's, you know, she does not have a body to leave. So she goes, "So look, the hegemony has been calling off lower level executives, and no one can figure out why. I was out on one of the rim worlds with no firewall, and I found an order to a local mining operation there, with a list of everyone who is going to be removed. Well, I found one of the guys who is was political dissident in his past and now is in a new life as an executive. I contacted him. His name was Ferris Calder. Well, I told him to get what he could and leave while he still could, like he was not dead yet. I think he got out. That was the last time. That was about 3 weeks ago. But now I've been trying to get, you know, to Ezra's hospital, so that's why I've been busy. And obviously you saw what happened when I tried to get into hospital. I got captured by another neural net. But look, that's past the point. What do you guys want to do?
So if we find this guy, we can figure out what's going on. I'm kind of confused.
Yes, so the documents that he possesses will give us more information about what the hegemony is planning. But it's something big enough that they would murder thousands of people within their own ranks to stop from getting out.
Okay, so let me get this straight. I'm asking you as the DM. The hegemony, they're like the biggest kind of...
They're a transnational corporation that, you know, is almost as big as its own, you know, state.
Yeah. And so they have been having this thing where a lot of lower level executives have been getting killed. She went to a mine where supposedly a bunch of people also got killed.
Where we're going to be killed. She found a manifest that was like of all everyone that was to be killed and stole that.
What?
And that is one of the documents that she has with her now.
Okay. And that's how she discovered this guy.
Yes, she saw the guy was on the list and was like cross-searching all of these people who existed, found that this guy had, you know, been in the past. He was like in college, he went to some rallies. And he was like a business major, so But
okay, this guy's deep state as fuck.
Yes.
Okay, so Niall, I'm gonna go on ahead and roll it to see if I give a shit about this.
There's a funny look on Andy's face, and he kind of turns away for a second.
I don't have time. Success. Okay. What funny look is on your face? Can you make it?
Is it like haha funny or like?
I'm thinking. I'm deep in thought.
Okay. Niall.
Since we started, go ahead.
No. Go. Because I was gonna wing something.
Since we started, like zooming, you see that Cygnus has been like doing this stress ball. But then as soon as B'Elanna mentioned Ferris Calder, he started doing him faster. But he hadn't said anything.
Niall, I guess, turns to B'Elanna. I guess I've been standing there the whole time. And I'm like, so, what is this guy? What does he have that we need?
B'Elanna sighs, and she says, look. And you see, for a moment, the only noticeable to you, Niall, because, again, you're operating at 2x speed, everyone. She seems to be, like, the frames on her, like, the little screen embedded in this device seem to be, like, lagging behind what she's trying to say. It's not synced with the image, and you can tell that this is probably because, there's something either wrong with her, engram, or this is, like, she's been limited by the device she's been in, or Something along the lines, but something is not right with her.
So does somebody do, like, is she, so is she, like, degraded? Or
That's what it seems like to you, or okay. something here is happening that is requiring more mental effort on her part than it would otherwise cost.
Okay, well, Niall sighs, and he's like, man, I was really hoping there'd be something, like, cooler going on, but, so, are you gonna just take us to this guy? Andy could probably handle him. Right, Andy, you feel confident, you want to be a pirate? He turns to you.
Pirate in the loose sense. In the sense that we were just free, I meant. And he turns around and he's finally like, you see he's like, almost like decided something just by his face. You can tell. And he turns to you guys and he says, listen, fellas, this job, you know, she's asking us to take on. It's not an easy job. It seems pretty difficult. We're going to have to go far, find a random guy. Maybe he'll give us information. But I see an opportunity here, fellas. You guys believe in a little something called fate? I look around. Nobody? Nobody says anything?
Belana shakes her head.
And Niall's like, absolutely not.
I don't believe in fate, Andy. I believe in putting your destiny in your own hands.
All right, Cygnus, well, I feel like we've been handed something today. I feel like this is an opportunity for us to bring peace to the galaxy. All right, and I feel like that's my calling. So let's fucking do this, guys. Let's fucking. I mean, if you guys want to make money along the way, I'll help you make money. You know, we're a crew. We're in this together. We'll suit up the ship. We're probably gonna have to bring peace to the galaxy. But let's fucking do that shit. That's our goal. That's my goal, personally.
So halfway through your speech while you were giving all that, Niall turns and is walking back to the station. And he puts his hand up and he says, you're the captain. And he just walks away.
Cygnus, listen, I need you guys in my corner.
I'm with you, Andy. Don't worry. Don't worry about tracking the sky. Trust me. I'm on it.
Okay, sounds cool. Listen, Banthony, you didn't really have much to say. Mind if I take that chip from you?
I do mind. You're not going to do that. I do this.
But
you need to understand our dynamic here. I'm your employee. You pay me and I do what you say. I don't really have to like jump on your bandwagon to do that. You can just keep paying me and I'll do the things you ask me to do.
All right. That's all the motivation you need for now. That's all the motivation I'm going to give you, I guess. But hey, listen, Anthony, one day we can make money and purpose. Let's start thinking about that, buddy, moving forward. I turn back to, I start walking to Niall. Niall, so do you got the coordinates? You know where we're going? You got this set up?
I don't know. Do I, Alex? How would we know where to go?
Yeah, the Blonda says, well, that's the thing, as she says from the pocket of Anthony Bourdine. Okay. I think that, I mean, are we in range of a drop net transceiver? And she, like, looks on the navigation thing. She goes, oh, looks like we're coming up on one now. Look, Niall, tune into any one of the freaking news stations. I'm sure they're going to be running things. I mean, Silverflower just died.
Oh, yeah, true.
Yeah.
Okay, so I what do I need to roll for that? It's a computer not, hacking?
No, you don't have that. This is just, this is like a computer.
Oh, this is tune into the publicly available one.
Yeah, just.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
So okay. You flip it on, and there's like, there's an animatronic ferret that is like one of these uplifted animals that is cybernetically enhanced. But he's like a news host, but he's like a ferret.
Okay.
And, so that's what you see. He's standing there with a microphone in his hands and he goes, we're getting reports in that Jeffery Silverflower has just been killed in the dead zone. The people responsible for his death are still unknown, suspected to be at large. We're getting it now. And they pull up behind him. He shows, it's like a readout. You recognize this as a transceiver readout, like an identifier. He says, this is suspected, the last people seen with Jeffery Silverflower were in the ship of this transceiver code.
Andy's shaking his head at the TV and he looks around. He's like, how do they know we're large? he's so confused.
Anthony laughs.
Was there anyone else, maybe someone else on their ship must have still been alive. Maybe they didn't send everyone out into the what's it called, the airway, and they alerted the authorities.
Maybe
it's like surprised this is happening. The man of just died back there.
I guess not. Listen, I think we're going to have to spend these credits as fast as possible. I whip out, like, the... Is it, like, a card that these things are on?
Yes, so they're, like, kind of, like, they're, like, little cards with readouts on them. And, like, so it's, like, a little LCD panel that reads out how many credits that thing is worth. And those, I'm sure, I would... No! Oh, my God.
Just made it. I saw you flash resisted.
I turn to Niall. I'm like, Niall, you think you can get, like, his bank account numbers or anything from this card? Like, anything that can get us maybe more money? I mean, he's not going to be using it.
As you're asking me, I'm trying to do it. Can I? How can I do that?
Yes, this is going to be a hacking check, but it's going to be at a minus 10 because financial institutions are one of the most secure things in the galaxy.
Okay. Is there anything we can do to help that at all? Or no?
There could. If you got more information about this guy's like banking details, like if he had some personal information about him, yes.
Can we pretend we're his next of kin and pretend we're trying to pretend we're his kids or something? Division of retirement gets scammed all the time by people who serve people's kids.
I'm sure that works.
I think you're onto something, Anthony.
We're related to them.
Wait, guys, I think if we're gonna do another crime today, we should limit it to just one crime.
Well, I don't care. Yeah, I feel like we're just burying ourselves.
But I think I could probably get into this thing. We just try it, and then we'll go from there.
You know what I always say, a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush.
Yeah. I don't know what you mean.
I don't
mean,
know nothing about bushes. So how do I roll this one, Alex?
You've seen a bush before?
Scroll over a minus 10, and then I...
Yeah, and then you just click the check.
How about we try to get just a little more information about this guy? Maybe we look up some stuff, anything we can use. You know, I think anything, you can find his birthday. That's got to be online. You know, security questions is... His mother's maiden name, you know, this typical shit. We can get in there easier, you know.
What favorite kind of bushes?
You know. Bushes.
I guess I'll try to, like, so how would I, what's the equivalent to, like, Googling somebody in this universe? I just get on the drop net and start looking around about this guy?
Yeah, no, there's, like, centralized search engines that search, like, that index the entire drop net. But yeah, okay, you can search for this guy.
What role would that be? Programming? Or?
This would be, computer operations, technically. I don't know if you have that skill.
I don't even have that.
But roll it at your computer hacking level at least, because you're going to be good at operating a computer as you probably are at hacking one.
Okay, that makes me yeah, I feel like that makes sense. Okay.
Oh wow, you only made it by one.
Oh wow, that's crazy.
We're getting into this shit, bro.
Okay, so yeah, as you're like asking me, because I feel like I can consume the internet much faster because of my ultra time rate, so I could read like a bunch of articles. You can read a bunch of
Yeah,
because
you have a direct neural link and, like, you're perceiving time faster. So, yeah, you absolutely absorb a lot of this information very quickly. You learn all the default things, his age, height, name, last sign. Name, mother's maiden name, all the boring stuff. You go one level deeper after that. I'll give you on a success. You find some obscure forms about people talking about his personal life, some possible stalkers that tracked him different places. And you trace back his locations the past few days. There was a station in the rim that he was at for a very long time, like 4 days ago.
Oh, okay. And how was that the last place you went before where we pulled up on?
Yes, yeah.
This guy was hanging out at this place for a while. Is there any way for me to like beam it up in front of people so they can see it?
Absolutely. So you pull it up. I don't have a name for this. Give me 1 second.
No worries.
It is. Hold on. Let me get a good name for it.
You're good. So, anyways, I just have it up on the screen. Niall's like, I don't really care, but I just thought you guys might think it's kind of interesting. I don't know. I think I probably learned enough shit to get into to guess some security questions.
I'm looking at the the globe, like the holographic globe or whatever you're right. Projecting, and I'm like. I've never seen this place before in my life. It's definitely nothing to me. Cygnus, though, you're well traveled, right? Can you get anything from this?
Yeah.
What are you seeing? Actually...
What type of role would I have to make?
Okay, like a history.
There's like a so
an area knowledge.
Yeah, area knowledge skill. I think rolling it flat.
I have one.
As yeah, you want to roll one. Anything that
I'm rolling one on top of Joel's.
Yeah. So roll just with your IQ minus 2.
Am I able to put more points into like one of my stats, like on Foundry?
The way that you do it is you edit your profile sheet and re-import it. But you can do it in Foundry, but it makes things more complicated.
Is it harder to do it right now? Like, should I just wait till after?
You should probably just wait till after.
Okay, gotcha. Because I found out that my piloting is, like, super low.
If you want to, we can just say that you roll at what it would be. Or we could roll at one of your base stats for now, and then when you'll get the skill sorted out.
IQ minus two.
Okay, yeah. So you both know. So this place is called Doth 3. It is a super station in orbit around a red giant that is positioned in the rim close enough to the dead zone that a lot of like spacers go there as like a refueling point before making ventures in. So because of that being like a hub for people that are living life on the edge, it's a pretty like hostile place to be. Okay. And Alfonso, I'm going to say on your success, you know a guy there named Ulrich. He'd done some jobs for him before. He's a crazy dude. But he could also be... He's also the type of guy who would know how to hook you up with a new transponder.
Okay.
So that we could change the code? The ship.
Yeah.
I was going to ask you, Alex, because that was going to be my next question. Is there any way we'll... Well, actually, hold on. First of all, Niall goes, yeah, Andy, you never seen this place?
Yeah, I mean, look, when you're talking to Andy, you know, just imagine you're talking to a space toddler, because I've not been to most places now.
Oh, dude, they'd eat you alive in there. Niall started chuckling to himself a little bit, thinking of Andy and this. Is this place like Tortuga? It's like where the pirates hang out?
Yeah.
I hear that.
Imagining like... Andy getting bullied at Doth 3.
Listen, Niall, they could try to eat me alive, but I promise you I'm coming back. That much. That's all I'll say on that.
Okay.
You've got our accounts.
Well, there's probably a dude there that could fix our transponder. Alex, I wanted to know: is there any way that I could digitally alter this? Like, could I? Could I mask this in any way via?
Well, right now it's not super important. You absolutely could. You could. It would be very complex, and like you'd have to have again one of those spoofed Dropnet accounts to do it. Okay. But it's possible. It'd be really hard. Yeah, this was designed with some like the signals that are produced by like a specific crystal are like unique to that crystal, and that crystal is embedded in the transponder, and so you'd have to like digitally replicate one of these things, so it'd be very complicated.
What is the mechanism of this thing and how people can track us? Like, do they just know where we are? Do they know our location?
I tried to explain this last session. Whenever you're not in civilized space, you turn this transponder off so other people don't find you. And it doesn't really matter. But when you're in civilized space, you have to have it on, otherwise you'll get arrested.
You'll get pulled over.
Yeah, exactly. It's like driving without a license plate. That's the best way to think about it. It's like a license plate.
You're going to let us know whenever we go into civilized space.
Unless you guys specify otherwise, I'll try to let you know. Basically, anywhere that's not the rim or the dead zone of civilized space. Okay, gotcha. But if you don't say anything, I'm going to assume you're doing within the confines of the law or turning it off when you're going into the dead zone.
Sweet.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. So, you know, what do you guys want to do? I mean, I guess we could go there later if we need to. Where's this? Hold on. I'm getting sidetracked. Whole reason we did this was to fucking hack this guy's bank account.
Yeah, get in there. Let's see what's good.
I have absentmindedness. So do I know any shit? Can I lower that?
This will be at a minus -7 now because you know enough personal information that you would be able to fill out some forms to get past some of the initial suspicion.
Okay, you got that shit now. You got that shit.
IQ plus +5. Yes! Oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah. We're in.
We're rich now. We just broke the whole campaign.
You after filing some fake reports on pretending to be his child, you're able to get a routing number. However, this routing number that you get, you can take money out of, but you don't know how much money is there. And it could be being monitored by the people who are actually his descendants. But you have basically a blank check.
Okay. Niall goes, he turns to everybody. This all happens very quickly. He's like, oh, hey, guys, I'm in. He had some funny security questions there about his ex-wife. Does he have an ex-wife?
Absolutely. He has like 4.
He's also got 2 ex-husbands.
Oh, ooh. God. What a dork.
Yeah, this guy is crazy. Anyways, I'm in. We got kind of like a... Here's I guess it's like what some people would call an ethical dilemma. I don't care what you guys want to do. we could rob all this guy's money right now. His kids might find out. They might be like, where's the money? But nobody will be able to know that we took it.
Well, I mean, it's money earned on the backs of slaves and, you know, people he sold. So I don't think we should respect the institutions he's built at all. Period.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah, that's Andy. That's me. Hey,
listen, as somebody who's gotten away with some stuff, usually it's easier to get away with a lot of small things than one big thing.
Yeah.
My wisdom.
Okay.
I think we dip in every now and again with like little fake charges every time we need money.
I think that's the ticket. That's how I get around.
Well, so it was described as a blank check. Is it not a one-time check?
No, I think because there's a limit on if it's like a regular bank, there's also a limit on how much cash on hand they would even have to be able to like pay us. Yeah. And we don't know what this guy's asset. Like we don't know how much.
Yeah, and if you try to withdraw, if you withdraw more than you that's there, then it could bounce and you could like get the account locked down.
So
yeah,
when we try to,
I could probably do some finagling to see how much is in there though.
I'll let you roll for that.
Yeah, I should be able to get that information.
Again, but this could be at a fresh minus 10 because this is I'm not going to say it, minus 5 because you have access to the account, or at least
partially. Okay,
yeah, partially.
I was going to say, we're in partially, so yeah, I should be able to answer some stuff.
Nice.
Did I get it again?
Yes.
Yep. Let's go. Niall's a beast, dude.
So you go in and you see that this account, you're not able to get to direct readout of like how much money is in there. But you're able to see deposits and withdrawals. This looks like the pattern of deposits. Actually, roll. You have like a. There's a finance thing. I don't know.
No, I don't.
Here, let me. I think I can do. Nope, that didn't work. Okay, I thought I could do a on the fly thing. Anyways, roll IQ minus 3, because you don't have the skill. Everyone can make this roll if they want to.
Dang, that's crazy.
That's a crit.
That's insane.
I'm Rain Man, dude. Holy shit.
Okay. You're pulling this up. Like, what? Describe the situation here, Niall, as like you're doing this. Is everyone grouped around you? Or
so what? Yeah, I would imagine Niall has installed kind of like a drop-down projector screen in the middle of the ship so that everybody can kind of see it from their stations without having to get up.
Okay.
And we've all got the headphones on. So it's kind of like sharing a screen.
Like a main view screen that you would use to like look out the ship or something.
Yeah. Except Niall's operating through all this mentally. So there's like no cursor or anything. You can see things happening, but he's just fucking like moving around. But anyways, he pulls this page up and it's of all the transactions and withdrawals. It's everything. It's this guy's history, right? We don't know how much is in there, but we can see everything that's been done. And I'm just kind of scrolling through it. And I guess, Andy, you're sitting.
You're scrolling so fast and my eyes start to glaze over. And somehow the numbers like are floating around in my head. I think it's just a function of Admiral Andy's that they're like designed to have really good like math abilities. Like
that makes sense.
Yeah, I would assume so that they'd be very good at making battle calculations and like things like that. So
I don't know. Like it's not. It hasn't. My character Andy doesn't know like what kind of class he is, but like maybe like whatever class of Admiral Andy would have needed high functioning like math skills or something.
Right.
Sure. I feel like you're having to like adjust trajectories and shit like that on the fly. Like it would make sense that you'd be good at math.
Yeah. No. Absolutely.
So, do I figure out exactly how much is in this bank?
You figure out within a factor of 10 how much is in this bank. You also realize in addition very many other things.
Yeah. There's a lot that you could read from this shit.
This looks to be some kind of like tax haven. That this is stationed in by the deposits and withdrawals, because there's not very many of them, and when they are, they're taking large sums in and out. You can tell that this is also being monitored by somebody, because you can notice there's a trend in the deposits and withdrawals that is specifically trending. I don't know how you would know this. Maybe Niall pulls up like some stats on like the tax haven that like tax havens. Maybe you mentioned something like that to him, like, and you say something like that, and he brings this up. You notice that it fluctuates depending upon the exchange rate of like currencies from, I have names for all these things that I'm forgetting them. From members of the Kedron Alliance, there's like a unified dollar, but they all have their local currencies. It's going between those two.
Okay.
So.
Wow.
And that's
the person. That's the person monitoring. Is they're switching the exchange rates? And shit
yeah,
like
you
that.
Know, you know, Jeffery Silverflower wasn't doing this himself. You know that this is beyond him. That he had someone managing this for him. But it's still actively being managed. It looks like up to this, like, till this moment.
Okay. Listen, Niall, you think we can do anything about this? There's clearly somebody watching over this account. You think you can maybe like change the account password or something now that we're in, and like jack this, boot this person out or something?
I feel like I would be able to. I mean, I have, like, I'm in. I've logged into a bunch of shit, but I'd have to roll for it, I'm sure.
This, and so, also, I'm going to warn you guys. I'm going to warn you at this point. You're doing something that is very illegal, and you are not the only hacker in this universe. There are people out here that whose job is to hunt down people like you. And so you got to be careful with the decisions that you make here on the net, because they will affect you just as much as decisions you make in real life.
Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
Yeah, so this is what Niall... Niall says, obviously you catch all this shit, Andy. Niall's like, oh yeah, you know, that would make sense with everything that's going on. Here's the kind of, once again, we're at this question, like, I don't really give a shit. It doesn't matter what happens. Like, we become criminals, we become pirates, whatever. It's up to you guys. I just want to hang out on this ship and be able to do my little stuff. So it's really up to y'all. Do we take this money? Because we're going to piss a lot of people off. I mean, this guy's clearly involved.
Oh, yeah, I didn't tell you. This is within a factor of 10 of at least 100 million.
And we were going to get 500,000.
Yeah. Right? Mm-hmm.
So if we... Listen, fellas, 100 million. I mean, look, I'm good at math. I counted that high. There's that much money in there. I'm telling you. And I'm saying a one-time withdrawal... You know, what's it? I mean, first of all, what good is it doing sitting in a bank? I mean, who trusts banks anyways? Bad people. I'm telling you. We got to put this shit on the ship. Listen. Yes, we're going to make an enemy. I don't really know. I mean, how do I know about the hacking? Like, how do I know the stuff you just told us?
This is common knowledge.
I pulled it. Okay. Yeah. The tax haven stuff?
Oh, no. I'm sorry. I didn't know that's what you meant. I thought you meant, like, about the being tracked through. The net,
it being tracked.
So that's like, you know, that's criminal activity in this world. I mean, this happens all the time. There's people who have these brain computer interfaces that do crimes like this.
Yeah.
So it's like, this is the type of crime.
So I would assume, like, I've left no traces up until now, but like, once if we take this money, like, wherever, here, this is what Niall says. Listen, man, I don't know if you've, like, really ever thought about this, but like, what the fuck is money? What do you think it is? I gotta put it. We're gonna have to. We steal all this money. It's gotta go somewhere, man. We can't just like. We can't. We gotta put it somewhere. Someone's gonna see. That's a fuck ton of money. Where'd you get that?
It is a fuck ton of money. It is.
We try to start spending it. Is there like an equivalent of like the IRS? Can we get audited if we're fucking running up a tab?
There is, but it's not very hard to get around right now because of the way states are broken up.
And Niall, we're gonna get attacked by the IRS anyways. We're gonna be making a profit illegally as pirates. I'm just saying.
You're misunderstanding me, man. I'm not saying that I give a fuck what we do. I'm just saying you might not be thinking this all the way through. And before you make whatever decision you make, you should think about negative repercussions.
Hey.
It seems like there's a fucking war brewing between a lot of people that I really don't give a fuck about, so I'm not going to get, you know, I'm not going to speculate. But I'm sure that this dude was tied up in it. He's got this fucking, this tax haven with all these people pulling in and out of it. Who knows what that's for?
Okay, but let me ask you something.
He's
now.
Dead now.
You know,
he got this
war...
fucking bitch. I point at Banthony's pocket, hanging out with us. She's fuck, you know, who knows?
Okay, Niall, we've got a war coming, right? We got the hegemony. We've got whatever other groups were listed off earlier. I don't fucking know them. I don't even know what they do. But here's the thing about me, Niall, okay?
Uh-huh.
Those people are well-funded. Those people are well-armed. Those people are powerful. If we expect to be on the same level as these guys, we got to level the playing field some way. You understand what I'm saying? Money talks, baby. I'm telling you, how about we steal all this money, go down to this fucking Tortuga place, whip our dicks around, get the best fucking ship we can get, and leave the money there. And they're not going to say shit. We just spend all the money we can, buy shit, and we don't take, we give it to the poor. You know? I don't fucking care. I don't want all the money. I just want a badass ship a lot of weaponry that we can fucking take on the galaxy with. What? And Vanity, I see the hand, though. What do you got to say?
Hey, listen, boss. I wasn't the guy who said it, but I've heard before you're like a space toddler. And I think maybe your space toddler pants are a little bit bigger than your britches, if you know what I'm saying.
Hey.
This is, listen, you ramp up to that sort of activity, boss. We're not ramping. This is not a ramp. This is a cliff. This choice would be bad.
This is a wall.
This is a wall. Hey, listen, okay, I'm not going to say, because people have already said a lot about you being a space toddler. I'm not going to say it, but maybe space Napoleon complex. I'm just saying, take it step by step. We can have access to this bank account and not use it yet. Let's play our cards smartly.
Okay. I'm with Banthony and Nile here, Andy. Listen, you talk about being a space pirate. You talk about freedom. Where's your freedom if you're in prison from having done this? You're not going to be able to use any of it, all right? Let's play this smart.
I guess I was just hoping we wouldn't get caught, but let's...
Hold on. While you're talking about this, because Nile truly doesn't give a shit one way or the other, I've already thought it through. Is there a way that I could theoretically get this money, Alex? Like, through some kind of... I don't know how. Is there any way that I could do this, like, tracelessly, essentially?
I'm going to need you to...
Can I mask, whatever ID I'm using to access this system and move around in here? Is there any way I can...
Can I propose something? Go ahead. Like, maybe we use B'Elanna in some way? Like, because B'Elanna, maybe
Eat
we,
that
like...
Bitch away.
We get her into the system. She spreads throughout it, fucks up the entire banking system, has nothing to do with us, and it just looks like a series of major effects going on. We crash the free market. You know what I'm saying? But listen, I'm a space toddler. People keep saying it. I didn't say it first, probably.
A reminder is that B'Elanna got caught trying to break through a not very significant firewall.
She's not shit. She's bitch made. And she's going out. She's flickering.
Oh, shit, we should probably plug
her. Someone should probably talk to her. But...
No, hold on. We'll talk to her in a second. You were getting ready to say something when I asked
you. I want you to make... This is going to require... For you to do this tracelessly, this is going to require out-of-the-box thinking. I want you to make a straight IQ roll.
Straight IQ. Okay.
Great.
Let's see.
Because this is not just technical skills. This is coming up with a novel idea, a way to move this money. All right. Made it by two. You realize that if you take this money during like a peak period that's coming up, and you realize all this just by looking at the history, like graphs of the different money markets around here. If you take it out during one of the peaks, like when all the like money markets are changing, you might be able to convince whoever this manager is. It's probably most likely an AI, if you had to guess. You could maybe take the money. And at the same time, inject malware that makes it seem like this AI is malfunctioning. And so that the AI is blamed for this loss of money and not you.
Okay. I was also going to see if there was any way... I have that. Could I blame it on one of the other people that's in the account? Because I'm assuming that all these people pulling in and out of this are like different political factions and they're all kind of working together towards a common goal. I could probably
ask our
cause some shit if I like made it seem like it was one of them.
I'm going to say on a good enough programming check, on a programming check at a -5, you can write malware that seems like it was from somewhere else.
Okay, so I can either do that at a -5 or I can do the thing with the AI that is there.
No, I'm saying...
It's about the same thing.
Yeah,
the malware itself.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, and if you fail it, we just go to the other option if we do anything. And listen, guys, I don't want to look like, we're going to do this. This is democracy here. Yeah.
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off. No. When you make this check, Mike, because you don't know how good the malware is until you try it, it's going to be a blind roll.
Ooh,
okay.
That's scary.
Okay. Oh, man. So this is what I relay all this. I'm like, well, look, guys, here's the deal. I can probably find a way to get this money out of here. And two things will end up happening. One. If I get it, and we get the money, and we probably had serious trouble being able to use it, but we probably could go to, you know, DOF 3 and get some dope shit and get out of there before anybody knew anything. Two, I write this program. It doesn't work. And we become targets of some of the, you know, richest and most powerful people in the room. for whatever reason, a political conflict that we know nothing about. Or at least, speaking for myself, I know nothing about. But hey, we could have a lot of money, and we could maybe pull it off. So, you know, you're the captain.
Okay. Why don't we inject the malware into B'Elanna and see if it works that way?
I still have free will, you know, she says from like, the vest pocket.
You're dying, B'Elanna. You're dying.
I'm not dying, she says, and she's continuing this thing, but now it's noticeable to everybody.
How do we stop the flickering? How do we stop that?
Can I just please be put in something that is not a mobile power source, for the love of God? I've been in this thing for 20 days.
Can we disconnect Grittybot from the network and then just plug her into Grittybot?
I don't want her in Grittybot, but sure, we can do that.
Nah, well, that way she's not part of the ship.
That's true.
That makes
sense. I
swallowed it.
You did you?
No.
He's all.
I didn't swallow through my throat, but it's in my mouth.
Oh, okay. Now she can't hear us talk. Perfect thinking, man.
I'm so anxious if he's gonna ask.
So, you know, this leaves us. Am I trying to hack this guy's shit or not? Cause like I'm down to try it. I haven't had this much fun in a while. It'd be a pretty big task.
Nah, but I'm just weighing the cost benefit analysis here. I'm just like, yeah. There's a way bigger risk if we fail than if we succeed.
It's pretty much
think?
Not hey, worth it.
As yeah. pirates, I don't know about this being our first move. First thing we do off the bat.
Be a pretty baller first move.
It would really cement us as the truest pirates there are. But you know what, Niall? A wise man once said to me, I put my hand on your shoulder, Niall. A wise man once said to me, what is money? Let's take the $500,000 he was already going to give us, maybe take a little bit more with that other thing you were talking about where you pull on a certain day. Let's just take what we got, soup the ship up any way we can, and get out of here. $500,000 could be plenty. We'll make more money down the line. And look, we'll always hold on to the chip. It's always down the line.
Yeah, I'm assuming I have access to this account now. I would imagine, right, Alex? Like,
you have the ability. You can pull. You can do whatever you want now. But right now, it'll be seen like what you do, as like a third party is in this account, and the account needs to be frozen.
Okay. Yeah.
So if we take our money out,
it's a thing we have to do. Like
our money's already in like a prepaid, isn't it?
Yeah, he gave us the money on a separate thing, I believe.
Yeah, that's like physical currency. You have it now.
Yeah. So this is his bank account. So I have to make the decision. If we take anything from it, we might as well go for all of it. Because one way or the other, I can't mask. I don't think I can mask.
I'll let you write
this malware to mask my shit.
Right I'll away. Let you write the malware to grift all of every transaction and give you money. That'll be way easier than to take all the money and not be blamed on you.
Okay, I see. All right, so yeah, it's a choice that, you know, I'm going to leave it up to you guys to make, because I don't care. But I say you're the captain, Andy.
Well, my crew's speaking out against it. Let me say one final thing. Cyphus? What is it again?
Cygnus, how many times do I have to tell you? It's
Cygnus. <He's> so bad.
How many times do I have to tell people how to talk? How to pronounce my name.
You got to roll short temper for that. You got to see if you pass. No.
Yeah, I agree. You have to roll bad temper on that.
You got
to
roll.
Right. I know.
You're squeezing that stress ball.
He just shoots me in the head. I die. I fucking die.
You resisted. So you got a little mad. You got a little mad. You had to squeeze the ball.
I got a little mad and I go, it's sickness.
Ah. All right, turn it up. God. Turn a little green there for a second. You're worried.
Envious.
Cygnus, what do you got going on?
What's the deal?
No, like in terms of like your future, like I mean, where do you see yourself? Because you're squeezing a range ball right now. You're pissed off, and I just
wound up, man.
All right, that anger, you know where it's coming from? You know where I see that coming from? I see it coming from your heart, Cygnus. It's on tilt.
Yeah, no shit.
Okay.
Oh. Listen,
the only way to set your heart right is to live with conviction, my friend. You got to do what you got to do.
That's right.
To bring peace to the galaxy. Okay?
Okay, Andy. I hear you.
So are you pro or anti stealing all this guy's money, Cygnus? I'm just gonna kind of go around the room.
Like I said, I just feel like maybe we wait for a better moment, maybe where we won't get found out. We can keep it in our back pocket. We have the information. I just feel like we've already gonna have people coming after us for this. Why add another thing to the pile for people to chase after us for?
Fair enough. I'm with the group. If we're not gonna do it, we're not gonna do it. We can move on.
I have a question, Alex.
Mm-hmm.
Could I, if I had a one of those spoofs, would there be any way that I could start like creating a bunch of fake accounts online and starting like and writing and starting rumors about who actually killed this guy?
I'd say that you're able to do that without a spoofed account. The only thing, if you want this, is you'd need a spoofed account to make it not traceable back to you.
Okay.
But you could start, like, if you didn't really care about that, you could start it to make, like, if you want to try to start a misinformation campaign or something like that.
Yeah, I don't want to do it and have it be traced. I feel like that's, Niles would never do anything that would be traceable, so he knows to wait.
Okay.
But that's just something I want to have in my back pocket, because I feel like we need to be able to...
Yeah, you're gonna be able to buy, like, those accounts. There's people that sell them here at Doth, so...
Okay, and now Doth 3, is that also where this Ferris Calder is?
No. Ferris Calder is not there.
Okay.
We still have to make a check to find out where he is, right?
Yeah, but Lana doesn't even know where he is.
Lana's in Banthony's mouth, so...
you might spin out the girl. We kind of need her. hey, Banthony.
is she still in his mouth?
You care if I get that chip back? We're going to put it in a grid. Are you eating more? What are you? There's nothing edible on this ship. I'm telling
you. It's just still in my mouth.
Oh, okay. Listen, Anthony. I mean, what made you want to steal that?
What's your deal?
Yeah. Like, to me, it looks like your heart's on tilt.
I'm gonna roll short tail.
Oh, God. Man, we
got a couple
lines. Stabbed me.
Man, I make minimum wage. Leave me the fuck alone.
Whoa. Nah, he's gonna really make you minimum wage.
Hey, Anthony, you need this stress ball.
Am I the guy that's that pays everybody? I thought we were paid by the.
No, you guys were being contracted out by the Make. So.
Yeah, Niall goes, listen, dude, I didn't want to step in, but there's a fundamental misunderstanding of the relationship on this ship. I own the ship. None of us really work for each other at all. I just kind of own the ship. I work for whatever those fucking dudes are called.
I can't remember Niall what they're called.
Well.
are you fucking telling me we're not paying these guys right now? He's pissed off.
Andy, dude. I'm really thinking you don't know how money works. Listen, they're being paid by the... What are they called? The smiling... they had a name. I don't remember. Happy Freight?
Make.
Yeah, those guys. Yeah,
Happy Face is my campaign.
Make Make's paying all of us, man. Do you
we don't work paid? For Make Make anymore.
No, here's the thing. You just made that decision. We were on our way to Silver... We still have a boss, man. We were on our way to Silverflower on work. He's fucking dead. And you just said... I'm saying all this very quietly. You just said, quote... Let's be pirates. Now, I'm not trying to call anyone a toddler. But I really don't think you're thinking of all the moving parts.
Four hands got raised, Niall. We're pirates, bro. Let's take the money from Silverflower, divvy it up. I'm talking like maybe like five. You know, maybe everyone gets 1,000. You know, credits and then 2,000 to you because we do shit maintenance. You know, let's pay these guys so they're fucking loyal.
So, okay. Now says, listen, man, I don't give a shit how much you pay them. As long as I got enough money to keep the ship running, it's whatever. but I really, you know, there's gonna, like, we're gonna have to, like, put in a 2 weeks or something.
They're gonna, so what, they're gonna put it on a resume? No, like,
hold on. Can me and Cygnus, can I get to hear these people?
Dude, this had a plus two because I feel like this has been going on for a while. You guys are all in the same room.
What kind of thing do I roll?
Extended one.
They beat our asses, dude.
The thing that set me off is that I would have seen you say pay.
Set me off. Me too. I have greed, man.
I got greed, man. They hear Andy go, "You're telling me we can't pay these guys?"
Yeah. So. Yeah, you both, I mean, yeah, you guys both hear it.
I go to Cygnus, I say, Cygnus, buddy, last time one of my bosses said pay, I started getting Amazon and Walgreens gift cards instead of money. I can't live like that no more, Cygnus. I say we take the ship over.
Can I roll to hear that?
You see that Cygnus takes you off to the side and then takes out one of his guns from his holster. You say you started mutiny.
Dude, Niall notices this. I feel like I would see this happening because everything's going so slow. I turned to Andy and I say, "Listen, man, I just briefed you on how contracts work. It might be smart of you to brief them.
Yeah,
we're doing a mutiny over there. I need you." Niall grabs you. He grabs you and he says, "Listen, dude, respectfully, I don't give a fuck about anything that happens, but I don't want to lose this shit. So you gotta fucking be a captain. Rally the troops, dude. Figure it out. Because make a decision. What are we doing here?
All right.
We pirates or not? You're the captain.
I roll
it all out.
Okay, I pat Niall on the back and turn to you guys. I see Cygnus's gun out. And I say, buddy, gun out. You're whipping it out on me. I know you saw my friend Niall go pay. And that was probably a big red flag for you guys. But let me clear something up for you guys. You keep saying you're an employee. I just want to – the dynamics are changing, guys. We're fugitives from the law, probably. That silver flower
– no shit. Whose fault is that?
Whose fault? That's – I don't know. Whoever fucking sabotaged us and made us blind jump, maybe the fucking chip in his mouth, maybe. That's whose fault it is. But listen, guys. Here's the thing. You guys saw this because I wasn't sure exactly what the new dynamic was. So here, let me pitch it to you. We have 500,000 units. All right? I'm thinking 100,000 for you, Cygnus. 100,000 for you, Banthony. I keep 100,000 myself. 1,000 to my dog, what's his name? 1,000 to my dog, Niall. And then we're putting 1,000 into the ship's fund in terms of, like, you know, or 100,000, you know what I'm saying?
And now it looks like he's about to step in and he steps back.
Are you sure that you counted that money right when you were doing the banking account?
Yeah, yes. 1,000. You know what I meant. 100,000. What's the most amount of money you've ever seen, Cygnus?
How much would I have seen for my work as a bounty hunter, or history or something? Like
you that? Would have done. I'm sure that you would have done. At some point, like, things where 2 million was exchanged between people.
But as a take, though,
as a take. You probably at most took like one mil at the most.
Probably a million large.
Hey, it starts small, buddy. What about you, Banthony? You've lived on kitchens your whole life. What's the most amount of money you've ever seen?
You're living on kitchens.
The amount of money you have in your hand.
That's what I'm saying, buddy. Now listen. You don't want to be loyal to me. That's fine. Let me earn it. But one thing I know you guys can be loyal to is cha-ching, look right here. There's fucking bags of money in my hand. Let me pay you guys. Let's keep this thing going. I'll pay you better than Makes ever paid you. Every job we do, it gets split four ways, and whatever's left over goes into the divvy. It goes into the ship's fund. And then, you know, I mean, what's that different? We're just going to pick up jobs. It's just we're cutting out the middleman. No more Make. We're fucking independent contractors now.
I mean, yeah, that's basically what I already was, so fine by me.
Fine by me. Are we cool? Cool.
Okay. Well, Niall doesn't have an opinion because you'd think after working for this company for 100 years, he would have, and them gifting him the ship, he'd have some kind of loyalty or connection to them, but there's nothing. He does not care about them. So he's like, all right, that's what we're doing then.
So now you own the ship. It's not like a type of thing where you're paying make for this. You like fully, it's in your name, right?
That's a great question. I'm going to assume so because it was never said that that's not how it works.
Yeah, and when I said it's your ship, I'm not going to say, well, actually, it was their ship.
Actually, you're making payments. You have a 7-year lease.
No, yeah, I'm going to say that you, after 100 years of this company, yeah, you were trusted enough to be given this ship.
Yeah, I've kind of got like a perfect record until you guys got on my crew. I've never had a murder happen.
Jobs. Maybe there's a way. Mine. Niall, you're in good with Make. You've been with them a long time.
Yeah.
Let me ask you a question. Do you think there's any way maybe we can, one, either fake the explosion of our ship, make it look like we all died so we don't owe them anything? Or two, maybe just get in touch with the boss and maybe clarify things were an accident. Maybe we continue working for Make, but just kind of doing whatever we want.
Oh, yeah, man. I mean, people are stupid. I could trick anybody if I had the right tools. I mean, I feel like I've already got a little plan cooked up. I just need to get somewhere where I can buy some spoofs because right now I'm kind of worthless. It's kind of like I'm just putting my fingerprints all over the internet if I do anything. That's why I can't fuck with this guy's bank account. Because if I had a spoof, Alex, right, technically what I could do, since I'd be masking my, like, the user that I am with that thing, I wouldn't, even if I pulled money out of that account, they'd be able to see somebody took it, but it would be under that spoof and not under mine.
Right, but the people who specialize in this kind of cybercrime go through, like, they, one of the things that they do is go undercover and go to these spoof sites, see who they're dealing with. It's kind of like a drug dealing kind of thing. So it's like,
I see.
If no one would know that you're the one who, you know, you had these drugs. But
they might
know
that I had a spoof and I'm known as someone who could do something.
Exactly.
Like that.
So
they put two and two together. I see. Well, still, my plan is, listen, guys, I was thinking if I get some spoofs, you know, I could start planting seeds of, like, disinformation and stuff, saying that, like, you know, there was some third party showed up and just kind of wasted us and Jeff while they were on the ship. Did they get his body? What happened? He floated off into space, right?
Yeah, his body, I think
well, dude, cut to it and it's just
I think it was like flash frozen, and then due to the gravitational forces of you going to warp, it ripped into a million pieces.
Okay. Yeah, his body's gone.
Yeah.
How did he die again? I don't even remember. We didn't kill
ejected,
him, did
we? He just shot out an airlock.
Yeah, the airlock just opened into space, and he just flopped against his own ship.
Yeah, so I guess there are people on his ship that would have seen what happened, though.
That's what I was thinking.
You can guess that's probably how this word got out.
Yeah. Well, anyways, I'm cooking up some stuff, so, I mean, I could probably find a way to... It's just our word against theirs, and they could say that they saw us just kind of leave.
Well, listen, we got some money left over in the ship's fund. Maybe we could bribe those guys even. Here's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking, let's go to Doth 3 right now. Figure out the logistics of what we need to buy, what we need to pay. Let's get everything handled. Contact Make, and let's get this party going. And look, I'll be the first to say I don't want to talk to B'Elanna. I think we need to talk to B'Elanna. I think we need to get out of this man's stomach. I think he swallowed it.
He's just going to tell us to go fucking find this guy. He's just going to say there's a war and it's all important and stuff. Maybe we need to be better pirates before we go to war.
Yeah, that's true. Well, what if we hook her up to Gritty Bot, like I was saying? You know, so at least, like, she's not fucking dying on a microchip. She could be useful.
Niall looks over at Grittybot, which is like his passion project, and he looks back and he's like, "Nah, but I have something else." And he walks in there. Niall, fun fact about Niall, he's got a box under his little table of all these trinkets and stuff that he's made. And Alex, I'm gonna ask you as a DM if I can pull out a little baby Cortana-sized figure. You know, like artists have those dudes that they use to like.
Yeah, it's like a holographic one of those.
It's one of those. And I'm like, I could probably fit her in this thing.
Oh, nice. So it's like a tiny robot. We could just put her into like a toaster or something.
Nah, she can have this. I just don't want to put her in Grittybot because I'm cooking some shit up with Grittybot.
Yeah, I'm gonna let you cook, Niall.
Niall looks at Gritty Bot and he immediately starts.
He's been gritting the whole time.
Oh, that's true. He never stopped. Yeah, Niall looks fondly at how he's gritting until there's something poetic about it.
Okay, so let me get this right. This is a little animatronic, right?
Yeah. It's like a little robot.
Okay.
It's like a little action figure sized robot, maybe like this tall, like 6 inches tall.
Okay. You would take, what you'd have to do is, because that thing is not going to have the computing power to host like a full human engram. You'd have to, you could set up a, like a brain box that could link to this thing. And that could be its only form of communication with the world.
Okay. I'll do that.
This thing's not connected to our ship, right? In any way?
No, no. Not if you do this.
No. So I would roll what?
Do you have electronic?
I have
electrical engineering or something.
No, I have engineer, but this for starships.
Roll that.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, that doesn't look good. Oh, did I get it?
Yeah, you did fine. Nice. So go without problems. You make this thing. Just spare parts you have lying around. Do you hook her up and let her go? How do you guys get it from Anthony?
Oh yeah, no, hold on. Yeah, I walk over with the bot and I'm like, hey man, you can keep sucking on the chip, but can I just borrow it for a second to get the good part out?
So is it like, it's like a big heavy box and there's like a line and it's like a little like tiny animatronic that's like stuck to the box and like
on? No, it's like a wireless link. Like it's wirelessly linked.
Oh, okay.
It's like she's hooked up to an Alexa. Okay, basically, like a speaker.
Yeah, she's like a Bluetooth to this box.
Yeah.
Anthony gives.
Mm-hmm.
Niall just kind of looks at you. He's like, we gotta figure out what's going on here. he just walks away. And I go to plug her into my little baby bot.
Okay.
Blana baby. Baby Blana.
So you slot her in, you see that the chip, the light, like the indicator light turns off. And the light on your box turns on, and the robot animates, and you can see it's walking around. It stumbles a little bit, and says, "Finally, I'm out of that chip. The voice is really high pitched." So she goes, "Anyways, what I was going to say before I started running out of power was that, well." I mean, the guy, there's an information broker. I think that you guys might have known him. I think I heard you talking about him. Ulrich. He might know where, where Ferris is. We could maybe, he might have the information. We could pay him for it. That's the last thing I knew before I kind of got caught. I would love to have a bigger body at some point. I don't know if I'm part of this crew yet or not, or how this works. Because I'm kind of stuck here, so I feel like I should be part of the crew.
I lean down, and I crouch, and I look Blana in the eyes.
Oh, you're laying down. You'd have to lay down prone.
I don't do that. I'm squatting.
Do human engrams get a cut of the pay?
Yeah, do you need a cut of the pay, Blana?
Don't ask her if she needs it, because everyone's going to say yes.
Well, if anything, Niall's also practically a human engram.
Yeah, he walks around though. He's got his own little body and stuff.
True. Listen, Blana, we would love you to be part of the crew. We just can't pay you right now.
Can you give me a body that's not this?
I'll tell you what, Blana.
Nah, you gotta earn it. You already tried to do some fuck shit when we were back on that ship a while ago.
You did try to trick us, Blana. I mean, listen, our self-preservation is strong here. We're really not trying to like fuck you over. We
don't
understand.
Take it the wrong way.
You know, we're interested in working with you. We're interested in helping you. Trust is something you got to build, my friend. And I'll tell you what, we're putting up, you know, boards and, you know, we're laying rebar and concrete. But you're the one who's got to pull. You got to set the structure up for the bridge. You got to drive the cars over and make sure it works.
I kind of got lost the metaphor there a little bit.
That's exactly how Andy handles every other movie. He gets confused and tries to figure out.
That's so perfect.
I guess.
Yeah, and also, I'm just not going to give you another body until you do something cool. Because so far, you've kind of only been a problem for us.
Look.
You got to understand.
I could be a pretty good engineer. I mean, I know that you obviously are a pretty good engineer. I mean, it looks like you've been handling the ship pretty well on your own. I kind of really don't have any skills to offer.
Hey, engineers usually get paid. That's not in the cards for you today.
I got a question, Alex.
What?
Could I put her, if I have, I don't have compartmentalized mind. Never mind, I probably can't do that. I was going to say, if I, like, integrate Blana into my head, like, can I just get a little bit of a boost on some of my stats? If, like, from having a second consciousness in there?
If you took the AI meta trait, I think you can do that. Because you have, like, modular skills or something like that.
I only have the machine meta trait, so no, I probably can't do that.
Okay. Well.
All good.
Yeah, no. I don't see any way that could happen.
Yeah, okay. Well, never mind. I was going to give her my body, but not happening, bitch.
Listen, Niall, I mean, I hate to keep beating a dead horse, but maybe we put her in Gritty Bot. Maybe we put her in Gritty Bot. I mean, you can still cook with Gritty Bot just with her, just offline.
A new body. Fine.
I could do work for. I'll work for you guys.
Shut up. I'm digging around in a box. I'm pulling parts out. Niall's working on a body for.
I just imagine you just like kicking her out of the way. That was very funny. What were you saying, Andy?
I want to walk back over to Balana, and I'm like, I pick her up, I hold her on my shoulder. She's going to be my little pal from now on.
She turns into Jiminy Cricket.
Yeah.
Oh, you're horrible. Monster, you're a horrible monster.
All right, so can we start heading to Doth 3 now or whatever?
You're the captain, bro. You make these calls, my boy. Niall said his computer fucking around on a robot now.
I got a
side quest.
I've got, like, a Pip-Boy style, like, big, like, ovular, like, green, or it's probably black. And
it's got
like
big ovaries on his wrist.
It's a gauntlet. I meant ovular. Like, it's
no,
ovular.
I know it. I know you, man.
So it's like a gauntlet, right? And I it's almost like a Pip-Boy, I think. And I push a couple buttons, and I'm like, all right, you know, I've transferred all the credits to you guys. You guys are officially paid. And don't think, you know, oh, we got a big amount of money from this loser. We're just going to steal. Trust me, there's more where that came from. You already know we have access to the bank account. We're planning on taking. You saw me read those numbers. Big numbers. Now you want to get rich. We might not take those numbers now, but we get stronger, more secure. We're draining the whole bank account. I'm talking draining. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, Stygnus?
Okay, if you say so, buddy.
All right, rev up the engines. We're heading to Doth 3 now. Let's head out. I get to my steering wheel.
Okay.
Walk in.
So Doth 3 is the place where we can find Ulrich?
Yeah, it's also the place where I can find my shit that I need. So I think it's
This is a convenient hub location, so I can group all these things at one in one location.
Yeah.
Nice.
It's Walmart.
Yeah.
Let me ask this. Is there anything while we're kind of taking off to get ready? I guess, do you need to set any world, like, any tone for as we warp up or whatever we do here?
Yeah, I was going to introduce you as you guys get here. So what happens is, I'm going to change the music to see if this fight music. This is the Halo Warthog theme. Skip this.
It's just the sound of a warthog. You wanted what, Trevor?
I want to fight so bad.
Dude, I'm kind of, I know.
You just fought with your manager school, your supervisor school.
Yeah.
So as you guys come out of warp around Doth 3, this is a red giant star in a trinary system. There's a space station orbiting the star with huge solar panels that are like these. It's like a half dome, and then on top of that is like a little spindly like structure that is the station itself. And like all it has little offshoots. It kind of looks like an organic living thing almost. And there's like a whole docking ring. There's all these ships. There's all like ships of huge like size. Some that look like they were scrapped together, but they're all like around this. And there's like light. There's like searchlights blasting out into space, like oscillating back and forth with like a sign that's like a sign that says like Doth 3 on it.
There we are.
I walk over to Banthony. I'm like, Banthony, when we head to this planet, I'm not really sure what our roles are going to be, but I think maybe you and I stick together. Yeah, when we get onto the space station, you and I, we stick together. You know, we go around and ask a couple questions. So our two objectives are we have to talk to Ulrich and we have to get the thing fixed.
Yes, we can and get Ulrich. A
new transponder here, yeah.
Yeah, he's also the one that can help you with that.
So here's what I'm thinking, fellas. Cygnus is at his own ship. Niall, you know what we need for the ship. How about you guys go? I'm also going to give you all my credits that I earned. I want you to buy as much as you can for this ship, get us suited up, get us ready to go. I'm going to head out with Banthony. We're going to try to find Ulrich, maybe ask him a couple questions. Does anyone here know Ulrich?
Cygnus. I do, right?
Yes.
Yeah, it makes sense. You should take Cygnus.
Yeah, maybe I take Cygnus in. Yeah. Is that cool with everybody?
Yeah. So Niall is just kind of standing next to Banthony, like reflecting on earlier, being like, we need to figure this out. And he's like, I could probably get all the stuff I need by myself.
Man, I make more than minimum wage. Just tell me what to do.
All right.
Hey, I'll be honest with you. There's no provisions in the ship. I don't know what y'all's plan was long term, but there's nothing to eat.
Oh yeah, well we can go and get some stuff. Are you a good fighter?
I would say so. I've scrapped.
Okay, because I need someone to protect me. And Niall, are we there?
You guys are on the docking ring right now, I'm assuming.
Yeah, Niall just starts walking out. Doesn't tell you to follow him, doesn't do anything, he just leaves.
I turn to Cygnus, and I'm like, well, Cygnus, from what you've told me, from what Niall was saying, this place does seem a little rough, so let's just be ready for anything down here. And, you know, maybe, I've got a few ideas kicking around in my noggin if we got to make an impression in here. I'm saying we find the biggest guy we can, and we beat him up, if we got to. We really got to make an impression here.
I think that we just, if we just have enough swagger and we just stroll in there, I think that's the only impression we'll need.
Roll for swagger.
Okay, I think we can do that. And I'm actually gonna pass you a knife right now. Listen, Cygnus, if it gets down and dirty and we're not making the impression we want to, I want you to turn on me and cut my hand off, or maybe a couple fingers or some shit. Make us look really like some intimidating motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying?
Are you capable of regenerating limbs?
I don't. Listen, I don't want to get into it. Just you do what you got to do. Make it look cool.
I'm just saying that I don't know why you'd want to make it to where you can't use your hands. It just seems like such an odd request.
Okay, yeah.
Unless you can, are you a starfish or something like that? Or like, what's the equivalent?
I can regenerate my limbs, yes.
Okay. That's cool. That's badass.
Yeah, so let's fuck it. I'm saying, look, you can take my fucking ear off if you want. Whatever we gotta do to make it fresh.
I can't hear music. Can you guys hear music?
Maybe we even get into a bar and we get into a fist fight. You bite my ear off, but we'll get there when we get there.
Yeah, we'll cross that system when we get to it.
Yep, we head off the ship too.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is we'll pick up with you guys going to get provisions and stuff for the ship. We'll start there.
Does Banthony follow me out when I leave?
How fast do you walk?
Slow.
Banthony is gonna have to quell his demons a little bit here. Okay. I follow you. No trouble.
Okay. Yeah. So, have I ever been to this place, Ox? I would assume maybe I have.
You've been here once or twice on a mission, like just stopping to refuel.
And I would have had a way of, like, before we, like, I would know my way around, right? Like,
you could have a map. Map. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm walking immediately to where, I guess, what would it be, like some kind of like general store or something like that where we would buy like food so that he could have
stuff. Yeah, there's provision stores for like specific, because this is like a station for ships, so like they have stockyard officers that are like have that kind of stuff.
Okay, and then as a DM, where would I go to get the spoofs that I want?
That's going to be a little bit more complicated. I'm going to need you to make a roll.
I need to be on the ship for that?
No, this is a strictly in-person kind of thing.
Okay.
Also, right on. You probably figure that this guy that you're going to might be the leader of like a lot of the criminal syndicates here, so you might be a good person to ask.
Ulrich,
yes.
As I'm slowly walking out of the room, Niall turns to Andy and says, "Hey, Captain."
Yeah, what's going on? Sorry.
I got one request. Do you think you can handle it?
Absolutely. What do you need me to do?
I need you to ask when you talk to Ulrich. I need you to ask him if he knows anybody I can get spoofs from.
Deal. You handle I'll do that? It. Yeah.
The Ranger way.
Yeah, give me a little bit more money and I'll buy some spoofs. Or I'll just message you.
Gotta buy it. Yeah, just figure out where they're at. Let me know. Okay. So I said all this. I was able to have this whole conversation while walking out of the room because of how obnoxiously slow I walk.
Okay. Yeah. Fair enough. All right, sir. Now you're on your way. Man.
Yep. Okay. So you guys approach this produce place, right?
Yeah. Well, I'm gonna be real with you, man. I don't like eat food, so you kind of got carte blanche here. If you want to just get what you need, just don't go crazy. What's like the... money wise.
I didn't hear that part because I was a little full. What's the status of this food stand? Is it like?
Is he gonna get angry?
Yeah, you need to like. Is this a Walmart? Is this a Publix? What am I looking at?
This is like not even. Whole this food? Is like a dollar store.
Oh
like,
Lord!
Like produce section.
Oh, I gag. I don't get mad. I just gag.
Oh, it's not good.
No.
Oh. I miss eating.
You ate? When'd you eat?
I just eat like food and stuff. When That's I was crazy. A person.
Yeah, I don't need the backstory, boss.
It's okay.
I look around. Where's the Whole Foods?
That's what I'm not on this station. This is not one. This is not civilized space. This is hard to get stuff out here.
Say that. Where's the Whole Foods?
Yeah, is there a behind the counter? Is there a, where is there the a restaurant Jones? Kitchen in this place?
There is like a bar and grill.
I go there.
Okay.
Hey, boss. Boss, I need to go directly to the supplier. We can follow. You can come. I think I can handle it if you want to do your tech stuff.
No, I can't really do anything till I hear from Andy, so I'll just come hang out. Niles is following you.
I get to this. I walk up to just. Actually, I don't. I go to the back. Well, I assume it's like a warehouse. Not the warehouse. You know, you ever been behind a restaurant? There's behind the restaurant vibes. It's infrastructure. Okay. Is there anybody there behind?
It's kind of hard to quantify behind because on a space station. But the, like, off the walkway, like during the service section, like where they would cart like garbage and stuff around, you can see that there's just a door with a keypad on it. There's no like guard or anything.
Nobody there. I knock on the door.
You hear clattering and you hear someone yell and it goes, "Linda, I swear to God, if you do that again, I'm going to kick you out of this kitchen." And then he opens the door. What?
Hold on.
What did Linda do?
I fail.
That bitch, Linda.
Oh no.
Someone open the door. You think it's fucking Linda? Who the fuck do you think you are?
This guy is going to try to punch you.
Oh.
Oh no.
Okay. Damn. Something about Linda. I said her name.
You said, "Oh, you think I'm Linda?" Never talk about Linda.
Linda's behind me. You can't be Linda.
This will this guy just be like, "What?" You speak and he just goes, "Pow."
Does he succeed? Hold on. I'm a martial artist.
So you get to roll defense.
How do I do that?
Fan thing. It depends on what this guy does.
Yeah, hold on. I'm sorry. I'm trying to come up with a name for him right now.
Linder.
Lindo.
Linden 4.
Lindo and Linda.
Okay. Sorry. Test. Okay, create. Okay, I got him now. He's gonna try to punch you. Okay, he hits, so now you get to roll active defense. You can roll dodge, or you can roll parry.
You can dodge or parry.
I think are the two things because you can't block.
How do I parry?
It's on your character sheet.
So essentially, it'll be at like your chance of success will be lower than if you dodge, but if you land it, I think you actually hit him, right, Alex?
Actually, that's what I thought too. But really, parry does
parry. How do I do that?
Yeah, that's.
Is it the 11 or the 0?
Hold on.
There's two columns. The one with the number, the one with the modifier looking for me.
I'm sorry.
I'm just gonna do this. You tell me if it's right. Okay. Was that it?
Where do you even see Perry at?
Where did you get aggressive Perry
it's
boxing?
A skill, aggressive Perry.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, fighter guy.
Oh, Perry would be on your maneuvers sheet. Also, that's where you can see that stuff.
Yeah. Is that where? Where did you see? Where did you find that?
It's in my character sheet.
Oh, I just made. I just made another check. Whoopsie. Okay. So let me see what aggressive Perry boxing does.
Punches him back. Okay, punch him with a little hand.
Okay. Okay, and you rolled, what, a 10?
Yes.
Okay.
I rolled an 11, 10 is success. Or something like that.
Alright, I'm gonna say you punch this guy. Roll damage.
How do I do that?
So you, oh man, you weave his shit and fucking and hit him? What a power move.
That's life in the kitchen. How do I roll damage?
There should be damage next to, it should be, here, let me check your character sheet. It's gonna be your basic thrust, I believe. It's up near your profile.
Is it natural attacks melee weapon? You see that?
Oh yeah, because you have stuff that's like that, yeah. So it'd be, unless you're gonna use your toenails, it's gonna be one of those.
No.
Okay.
Not yet.
Yeah, so it'd be the punch, the 1d plus 2 crushing.
What do you do to this guy? Walk me through
how. Yeah, explain
how much
to me.
Is 5 damage. Punch. Tell me, I'll tell you. How much is 5 damage?
That's enough to get. That gives him a major wound. I'm gonna say that you. Okay, you tell me what. Tell me what you do, and I'm gonna describe the major wound that he gets.
I think an aggressive block would be one that sets me up for a punch. So he just goes right haymaker, and I catch his hand, and so I'm holding him in place, and I pop him in the nose as quick as can be.
Absolutely, his nose is broken. It's like actively bleeding, and like he needs to go to a hospital to get this thing reset.
He'd be like, "Yeah, he's concussed."
No, he's like, he collapses. He collapses to both of his knees and goes. He goes into like shock.
I start slapping his face. I say, "Hey, we're all chefs here. Look at my fit."
He's looking up at you.
Hey, you can thank me. I just gave you some work comp time. Hey, I just need some help, chef to chef.
What? What do you need?
Listen, you live here. This is dribble that they got. I need what you use as supply. I'm sure you get it off station.
I do have a runner that goes every week.
Hey, I've got a small ship. This guy doesn't even eat. Look at his cracked ass. Listen, just give me some of that stuff. I'll give you the money for it. I just need anything that's better than that frozen pizza, Tostino's square pizza.
Dude, Banthony is just Sanji, bro. It's so cool.
Dude.
Okay.
It's so good.
Sorry. So yeah, what happens is you talk to this guy. You don't talk. You're talking to this guy as he's on his knees, like, with his blood streaming down his mouth.
Yeah, I'm comforting him, though.
And
he
says,
roll to go into shock, I think, right?
No, yeah, he went into shock. That was him not speaking.
Shocked.
And also just giving up. You see, Linda, was that her name?
Yes.
Yeah,
Linda in the background is like stirring a pot of water that was like about to overboil. And she's like looking back at what's happening. And she's kind of like pretending like she doesn't know what's going on. Yeah, she's trying to.
What was he thinking? Why did he think that Linda knocked on the door?
No, he was talking.
She dropped a pot.
No, yeah, he was yelling at her for something unrelated. When you rolled
she
up.
She was just fucking up in the kitchen getting domestic.
What a wonderful miscommunication.
I thought
Anthony's whole thing was he was just like, oh, the working class is being abused. And like,
nah, he's like, you think I'm Linda? Who the fuck you call her? Linda, bitch? That's what he said.
He just didn't like he was being emasculated.
And then the other guy said, immediate response was, I'm gonna punch you.
This guy has really bad anger issues. This guy's supposed to be like Gordon Ramsay.
That was his the 13th reason.
Yeah.
Oh no.
He was at his boiling point.
Linda just messed something up. It was like the worst time he could have done it to something. He could have done something.
Just fucked the whole table up.
Yeah. Okay.
What does he say?
He says, please, whatever you need, you can have.
I'm not stealing from you. Listen, is Linda a better business person than you? Because you literally punched me when I just said anything. I just said something.
Linda hears her name mentioned, and she sees the blood hitting the floor, and she's like starts to leave the room.
Hey Linda! Linda, I flashed the card. I flashed the card. Does that bring her back?
Which card?
The money card, whatever. Money card? However it's.
Let me roll for her. I'm gonna do a reaction roll at -3 because you saw this guy bleed out on the floor.
He's not bleeding. Listen.
She rolled a 4, so I'm gonna say that's good.
That is good.
Yeah, I'm gonna say that's a good reaction. So.
Wait. So.
Go ahead.
I was explaining to your colleague here. Listen, it's simple. I you have a supplier. I need supplies. I'm sure you have more than you need at this time. I will pay for it. No one's stealing anything. This man punched me. I'm sure you work with him. He doesn't seem like a very customer service oriented guy. You, Linda, you seem like you know what you're doing under the engine of the hood. You get me these supplies, I'll pay you. We're all square.
Linda doesn't say anything. She just goes and nods her head and like gestures for you to follow her.
So when we're rolling, we're trying to get the lower number, right?
Lower is better. So this is a reaction roll. So I'm going to say that because this is not her doing anything. This is determining how she reacts to the situation.
Okay, so if something is harder for us, it's plus something, right? And if it's easier, it's minus.
No, because the plus and minus affect the goalpost. So plus moves the goalpost up, negative moves the goalpost down. Gotcha. So negative numbers are still bad, positive numbers still
like bad. On that hacking roll that I had to roll earlier, Trev, I normally only need below a 17, which is like busted. Because that's basically impossible to fail. But with a minus 10, I have to get below a 7.
Cool. I didn't know if it was, I thought it was adding to the like number you roll.
Okay. No, yeah, sorry. I should have explained that. Yeah, but she leads you back to like their walk-in fridge and goes, whatever you need.
Sick. You got a dolly?
She nods. She comes back
this
in with like
a
dish.
Great song to put onto this.
She comes back out with the dish cart, and you just go to town. I'm guessing loading up this dish cart with like whatever you need.
It's hard work. I'm sweating. Niall isn't helping.
No, Niall's sitting down right next to the guy that's bleeding out of his nose.
Just looking at him.
And now I'm just talking to him. I'm like, so what's going on, man?
my fucking nose.
Yeah, that looks pretty shitty.
I had this thing fat growing on Risa.
He's instantly regretting talking to this man. I'm just briefly saying what I was doing. I'm not helping though.
Okay.
I don't want to continue world building with this gentleman.
Yeah, I want to know about the vat building in Risa.
I want to know about Linda, bro. What's she do to him? I'm getting chummy with the prep workers in the fridge. They're just cutting their things. This song's playing on the speakers.
You're pulling the for like, sure. You just have this on your phone speaker as you walk around.
That's it's in my front pocket.
Yeah.
I got this dolly loaded up. I'm risen up Linda. I'm having a great time. I'm in the kitchen. I'm comfortable here. No anger rolls. I'm having a great time.
Oh, that's so awesome.
Perfect. So everything goes off without a hitch. Linda's actually smiles at you a few times and like while she's helping you. And all the service workers seem to kind of take to you, and they all like you. They all say, who's the new chef? And, like, they're all, like, asking about you as they come in and out serving tables. They see the guy laying up against, like, the threshold of the door, and no one cares because everyone hates him. So, like, they're all fine with it. But, yeah, that's what happens.
So I pay them. I don't know how I would pay them. Maybe there's a Venmo.
We have credits. We could just, I think,
swap. Yeah. Linda goes.
Touch tips.
We don't own the restaurant. I don't care.
Not paying y'all. That's why I'm paying y'all.
Oh, you're paying us? Okay. And she goes, come here. And she like gestures for the servers.
Oh, I'm getting paid.
Yeah, we're getting paid? Okay. Yeah. So they all come. They talk amongst themselves and they say, whatever you think we're worth. I mean, up to you.
I don't know how you want to do provisions.
You have 100,000 yourself.
Yeah, well, also, it's up to you. You have 100,000, so you want to spend it.
I like to think that some of it is perishable. So I have 100,000. How much is, I have no idea what this currency would be. What would be, like, enough to stock, like, 4 people eating
For a while? For a while, it'd probably be, like, 3,000, I would assume. 3,000 credits.
I pay 5,000, because I think 3,000 would be what they pay. I pay 5 grand.
And so you pay 5,000 to these people, and they're getting to keep all the money and none of the losses because they don't own the food. Yeah. So they're all ecstatic, and they go, thank you. And then, like, one of them gives you a hug. And, like, this is probably the best. This is enough money to get off the station for these people.
Oh, so wholesome.
Yeah. Right. So they're all very thankful.
Got back to Niles sitting with his chef bleeding out. His whole crew is mutinying him. He's getting super cucked by Anthony. He's like, man, this is probably gotta be one of your worst days, huh? If you had to rank them. Just up there. Does he say anything?
He's just looking, he goes, who the fuck are you? Where are you?
What's going on?
Hey, man, what are you?
He staggers up, like he pushes himself up against the wall and he's trying to stand up. Do you guys stop him?
Oh, dude, just stay down, man.
Yeah, I think at this point I'm dollying out.
And yeah,
I give him a little space fruit. Okay. So for your troubles.
He kind of just looks at it and he looks at you and he knows not to try to do anything to you again. So he just like takes off his apron and walks out.
That's probably smart.
Bye-bye.
Okay. I think that ends that scene and you guys can dolly that back to the ship.
Nice. How much food did we get out of that? We didn't necessarily say how much. I mean, we took everything.
This was going to be enough for like 2 or 3 weeks. Nice. This is like 2 or 3 weeks of food.
It's good quality food.
I'm trying to get Anthony to teach me how to cook.
Please, though.
Yeah, you're gonna make burnt sausages.
All right,
you insulted his craft.
As you guys, as Cygnus and Admiral Andy approach the bar that this guy is at, called the Electron Spin, you hear like lasers going off, and you hear like las pistols and all this other stuff. You see someone gets thrown through a window onto the street. He's got a big burn on the side of his face. And it goes silent, and you can hear, Ulrich's voice go, they thought they could. And then you hear another voice say, they always do, don't they? And then Ulrich, you guys see now at this point, I'm assuming, have looked through this broken window. He's sitting down. He's got a burn that burned through some of his, reflect armor. And he's just sat down. He's pouring himself a drink.
So, real quick, what information do we need from this guy again? What is it exactly?
Get the new transponder for the ship, right? So they can't like know that was us.
Yes. So it's a new transponder.
And also find out about spoofs.
About spoofs. Talk to him about
that guy.
Yeah, that guy. Ferris.
Yeah, Ferris Calder.
Yes, Ferris Calder.
I love the idea of Andy trying to have like a subtle information gathering kind of conversation and just fumbling is like try not to give away the whole plan and that we just murdered somebody and giving it all away.
Hey, listen, Andy, I'll do the talking, all right?
If you feel like that's necessary, but listen, I mean, don't think less of me, you know?
Less of you. Of course not, buddy. I just, you know, me and this guy, we got a nice rapport, you know? I just don't want anything to happen to that. I hope you can understand.
Yeah, I'll jump in if I feel it necessary, but until then I'll be the silent one.
I mean, look at you. You're a tall, good-looking guy. I mean, you're going to have plenty of riz on you enough, so I think just you being there with me is going to help.
Absolutely. I'm going to go, and I want to actually really quick loot the body that like was thrown and see if I could find like any like money on him real quick.
God, you're a fucking vulture.
Oh my god.
I'm like, dude, what are you doing to me?
I got a plan.
I mean, come on.
You're inside of Ulrich as he watches you bend over. He says, Is that Cygnus Froster?
Oh, dang it, Andy. Ulrich, how's it going, buddy? I don't know this guy.
Oh, no. Who is this guy? I step forward and I toss this man, because he was clearly just in an altercation with this guy. So I toss this guy's coin purse to Ulrich. I'm like, for the new coat. And I just, you know, that was all I was trying to do. I wasn't trying to cause no problems.
Well, he catches it. He goes, well, thank you. What might your name be?
I'm Admiral Andy. Do we have a name for our ship?
I don't know. Do you, Captain?
No, I don't. No, we did. We did not. This would be your chance to lie if you want to.
I shouldn't. I don't. I don't feel it's right for me to just make up.
I think it would be an Andy thing to do to just.
Name true. That's true. That
I do think he would be the one. If true. If you have it in you to name it on the spot right now, I'm down to let it be the name.
I'm gonna come up with something stupid, dude. I don't know. I keep, for some reason, I'm having a wild intrusive. I'm just thinking ass blaster over and over again.
That's the name, then, dude. It sounds like that has to be the name.
Okay.
You're thinking of it.
My name's Admiral Andy, Captain of the Ass Blaster. that's all I say.
The Alabaster?
Yeah, the Alabaster. Yeah, absolutely. That's what I said.
Oh, I haven't heard of them, but I'm sure you'll do great things one day, especially if you know Cygnus here. Come in. He gestures. He says, maybe through the door, not the window.
Yeah. Cygnus walks in. Do you follow me, Andy?
Yeah, I walk in immediately. Like, I ask for a drink at the bar. Like, I'm trying to, like, blend in with you.
It's a normal occurrence for the bartender is kind of just, like, wiping the table still, and he pours you a drink.
What's the drinks that they have here?
I'm here.
So they have, like, a lot of them are mixed drinks, a lot of different high proof alcohols from across the galaxy. Like, everyone has a different way of distilling alcohol or some kind of hallucinogen from the plants native to their thing. I actually have some stuff set up. Psychology is the physiology of the brain is pretty similar across a lot of species, so a lot of these things work interchangeably, so a lot of other alien species can drink alcohol. So that's what it is. It's a lot of alcoholic drinks, a lot of mixed drinks. There is some, like, ales and things like that, if that's what you're more into, but mostly mixed drinks.
Okay.
Alright. I'll take a spritz on the rocks.
So, you see the bartender takes it, he nods, and he's gonna put it on Ulrich's tab. Ulrich looks at you and says, Cygnus, what are you here for?
Hey, listen, buddy. Long time no see. Good to see you. I'm going to need, listen, something's come up. I'm going to need one of those nice transponders that you've been so good to me getting.
Yeah, it's not the first time.
We got the cash for it. I just need, you know. I slide him over my the 100,000 that Andy gave me. How much?
He goes, normally Cygnus, for you, I would be willing to give it to you. But this is my last transponder. I need you to do something for me.
Okay, what you need?
I don't know if you've heard about this big bounty that's out on this guy, Ferris Calder. Have you been hunting this? I know you kind of keep your ear to the ground on those things. Know anything about
it? You see that Cygnus kind of, like, side-eyes Andy and then goes back to Ulrich and then, like, keeps doing it to, like, let him know that he doesn't want Andy to know about him, but that Cygnus does?
Oh, you know this guy?
I do, but I don't want you to know.
Okay. Yeah. I know that the Fallis guy is the guy we're looking for.
Yeah, yeah. Ferris is the guy that we all know about.
Yeah, but you guys don't know that he has a bounty.
I'm actually looking. I have a bounty on him.
Oh, I see. I'm an idiot.
So
I think you're looking at me to signal, like, he can tell us where this guy is. So I pretend to not even notice that you looked at me.
Okay. So Ulrich says, he sees you doing that, and he goes, would you prefer somewhere more private?
Sure.
Come with me to my back
here, Andy.
Let me come with you.
Ulrich turns and says, no offense. This is something for known parties only. I'm glad to meet you. He extends your hand and tries to give you a handshake.
I take his hand and I'm like, all right, but listen. Okay, fuck it. Yeah, all right. I take your hand.
Don't worry, Andy. This will just be a minute.
Yeah, you go on. Go ahead.
How does Andy process that?
What's he feeling? It kind of hits me that I think. Can I make, like, an IQ roll to see if I feel like Cygnus is hiding something from me?
I'm gonna say yes, but it's gonna be it's gonna be a quick competition between you and Cygnus.
Okay, I also have -2 to IQ based skills when alone. I have that.
Okay, so I put -2 on there.
Dude, you're rationalizing it that like no, I can't do that. This is my friend.
Okay, can you roll too, Joel? Just roll an IQ roll.
Like neutral or?
Just yeah, just a straight IQ roll.
Damn, you rolled a 7, Trev.
Okay, so yeah, you think that something's up.
I just let it go. I don't say anything about it.
All right.
But I know, in my heart.
Okay, so Ulrich takes you to... Oh, go ahead.
Is there any way I can, like, eavesdrop?
You maybe could. I was about to describe where they go. There's, like a VIP section with, a waterfall of, like, ribbons that get parted. Like, one of those kind of things. And they go into the back room through there.
I walk up to the nearest patron I can, like, the drunkest, most, like, poor-looking person in this room.
Okay.
Yeah. He's probably got his head down on a table. I grab him by the hair and tilt his head up. I'm like, want to make a quick buck, buddy?
let me roll a reaction roll for this.
I love your character so much, Trevor. He's such a vibe, dude.
Oh, that's high, bro. You can't.
The indomitable human.
He goes, leave me alone. Who are you?
Okay. I want to flash some money and kind of like drop his head almost like as an intimidation tactic.
Okay.
I want to drop his head so it bangs.
Oh, here comes the Sigma music.
So, do I make a roll for that?
No, I'm going to say that you just do it. So if you want to flash the money and hit his head on the table, that's what you do.
Listen, bozo, I'm trying to get you some paid. I see I'm looking at your coat right now, dude. Is that... That's Andorian leather. That shit's whack. So, listen, you want to make some money or what?
He goes, what's wrong with Andorian leather? He looks down at his suit and says, I just got this tailored yesterday.
Child slaves, you fucker. Listen, and I...
There's no ethical consumption under capitalism, he said.
Listen, buddy, I'm going to give you 1,000 units right now, and all I need you to do is listen to a conversation for me.
Okay, sure.
All right, head out the back window, loop around the... You see that room there? Sneak up to the window on the other side of the fucking building. I want to know every fucking word that goes on in that room. You understand?
All right, sure.
All right, you bring me back that information, another 1,000.
Okay, he goes and does it.
All right, sweet.
All right, so Cygnus, you sit down. Ulrich, like, unholsters the gun, his carbine off his back and lays it across the table. You see that it's, still glowing from the shots that he just fired. And he goes, so, Cygnus, what do you gotta tell me?
Well, I got in with this crew. Pretty cool guys. It seems like we're gonna be actually going after this Ferris guy, on our own. But I was already kind of looking out for him. Seems like he's system hopping. Last I heard, trying to get to the Terran Republic.
Makes sense. I think I have some more information for you about that. But look, Cygnus, I don't know how long it's been, how long you've been in the Dead Zone. The bounty on this guy is up to 15 million.
15 mil, wow.
Dead or alive. So, I'm thinking... I give you the information. I know that you have the ability to execute after that job. You, me, split half and half.
Sounds good to me.
Let's make it happen. He extends his hand.
Do we do the predator handshake?
Yeah.
All right.
So, that's what happens. And he goes, all right. Last I heard, he was outbound of this station, and he hands you a data pad with the coordinates of the last known location. I think that this is his last jump for the Terran Republic, so you might have to get around this pretty fast, unless you want to deal with some authorities.
All right.
But best of luck. Anything else you need?
Yeah, that transponder also, maybe where to find out about some spoofs.
So look, I trust you enough about the transponder that I'm willing to give this to you, pending the condition that you pursue this Ferris guy. So transponder's yours. Spoofs, I know a guy. I could set you up a meeting with him in an hour or two. Is that okay?
Of course.
All right. I'll make it happen. He'll meet you behind the electron spin. I'll see you.
All right. Sounds good.
And he grabs his carbine, puts it back on his back, goes back out. And the guy that was sitting in the corner that said, "They always do, don't they?" That guy, it's like a, he's an older guy. He's got like little glasses on. And he's just like typing on a data pad very flamboyantly. And he goes, "Are we ready, Ulrich?" And he goes, "Yeah, let's go." And like, he stands up and they both leave.
I'm sitting in the alleyway smoking. I have like a pack of cigars and I'm smoking them. And well, this guy, like when he gets off the window that he was listening to and he comes and relays all this information to me, I'm just sitting there listening.
Yeah, he goes, "Yeah, they said something about bounty. Ferris, I think was his name. Nah, it was really boring."
Did they tell you how much fucking the bounty is worth, or?
Oh, it was a lot. I remember. Yeah, they said like five million, 15 million, I think.
15 million. I wonder why. I'm wondering to myself why Cygnus has not mentioned this yet, but I am just like, all right, here's your units. Beat it, buddy. Have a good night. I threw an extra 500 on top, so I gave him 2,500 total.
Okay, so he says, "Thanks, mister," and he kind of like turns around like he just got free money. He walks away. Do you guys all meet back up at the ship, or what's going on?
Yeah, did me and Andy meet back up first?
Yeah. How do you guys meet?
When you come out of the building, I'm still sitting in the alleyway.
Andy, I thought you were still inside with your drink.
Finished it. Didn't think I needed it. What'd that guy tell you?
I think we're going to have to meet. We can get Andy. We get Nile to meet behind there in about an hour for a spoof. He gave me the transponder, right?
Yeah, he gave you like the bay location that it's at and like the rights to go get it. Because like it's stored on like storage on this station.
He said we can get the
transponder. Also, I got some more information about that guy, Ferris Calder.
Okay, what'd you learn?
Seems like I might be able to know where he's heading next. We can talk about it with everybody back at the ship.
Sweet. All right, let's head back.
So
I got my eye on Cygnus.
Okay. So as everyone is converging on the ship in the docking ring, there's a vibration in the ground. And you hear klaxons, like blare, and the station's under attack. And we'll end the session there.